Emuna class with Rav Shalom Arush, translated by Rav Dayan Elgrod. And we have the opportunity today to dedicate our Emuna class to the success of Charlie Harary. We apologize about the delay. There were just some technical issues, but we're going to give a big blessing to Charlie and all his beautiful students and friends and family, and blessings to our guests and all Yosef Daniel too, and his family and everything he's doing. We dedicate this class to both of their success and everything they're doing, and also to the full healing of Tova Leah Bas Rivka and Gedalia son Yerachmut Danil ben Tova Basher, and also to be rid of the coronavirus and all have a refuah shlema, especially after the tragedy of Meron. And we dedicate this class also to all the 40 holy souls, Avda ben Chaim L'Chaim. We appreciate your dedication to our Emuna classes and to the Rav teachings. And we wish you all a really good week of real comfort. And please share Emuna Global. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, again, we apologize for our delay, but we're going to go quickly through the feedback. Harav Moshe Weinberger, Shlita, is Gewaldig, someone wrote to us. We need more involvement between all the Yidden, since many are blessed with pursuing the same goal. Someone wrote this, exactly what both Rabbanim are talking about, of unity, even if our ideas on achieving it are different. Bezat Hashem. All the Jewish people should watch this special message. That was a beautiful reaction to Rav Moshe Weinberger. Amazing lessons. Thank you, Gedalia. Oh, thank you. And Hashem will see miracles. Shalom, I appreciate your teachings. May Hashem bless you and keep Am Yisrael Chai. That was to do with my class last week. Please continue to make these from Rav Arush videos daily. They're amazing. Emuna class of Yosef Daniel, Baruch Hashem, beautiful. We are looking forward to the next class. Much blessings to each and every one of you and your families. You are amazing, being middle of the road, yet more spiritual than most. A great ambassador of Hashem. That's right. Aslacha, bracha, v'simcha. And this was about Charlie, about to give our class. Let's go. So we're going to go now with our first question. But before we do, we like to have some music. It's been a really hard time. And we're going to play a song from Yosef Daniel to comfort us, and then we'll get into the class.
Let's sing one of the classics. Let's bring David the Melech into the picture.
Amen. David the Melech.
David Melech, Melech Israel.
David Melech, Melech Israel. David Melech, Melech Israel. Chai, chai, chai v'chayam. David Melech, Melech Israel. David Melech, Melech Israel. David Melech, Melech Israel. Chai, chai.
Beautiful.
Thank you, Yosef Daniel.
Thank you.
Yes. Emilio, how about you asking the first question today?
Okay, so I have feeling a lot of weight and responsibility since it's been so hard. We do have a lot of questions, but the main question is the tragedy of Meron, Emuna and comfort from Rav Shalom Arush and Charlie. The first question manifested is, how are we supposed to use regarding the tragedy of Meron or any tragedy that does not affect us personally? How can we say thank you for that? If something happens to me, how can and I can say it's Hashem, I don't understand, but it hurts. I know that you are doing the best for me, so thank you. But how do we do that when this happens to other people? From one of our followers.
כשדברים כאלה קורים לאנשים אחרים. כשזה קורה לי, אני יודע שזה לטובה. איך אומרים תודה על האסון במירון?
נכון, שאלה יפה וחשובה.
True, that's a very nice and important question.
ובאמת, וזה מסר, זה טוב מאוד, אני כתבתי ואני אומר כל הזמן, שאדם אומר תודה על היסורים שבאים עליו לבד.
I wrote, and I always say this, that when a person says thank you for all the difficulties that are with him, things that happen to him personally. When difficulties and hardships happen to your friend, And obviously, when these things happen to Klal Yisrael, certainly in such cases, you don't say thank you. You pray, you feel the agony, the pain that has happened to someone else. If a person says it's all for the best and is happy, then really and truly he has no emuna whatsoever. He has a heart of stone. And not only is he not a righteous person, but I don't want to use the word, he is exactly the opposite. Such agony, such anguish in the whole world. It's anguish and pain of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, of the Holy Shechina.
Why?
The agony and anguish of the families. Oh, the agony that these families have gone through and are going through. And so many people have fallen to sadness, to anxieties, to fears. Yesterday my grandson came to me and he said to me, "Grandfather, I'd like to speak to you." He was there in Meron and he saw some of the difficult cases that were there. And I spoke to him a lot. And I blessed him. And he said to me, "I can't eat." And so I made sure that he sleeps with me. In short, there's so much agony and pain because of what happened. Certainly we believe that everything that Hashem does is for the better good. It's not a contradiction. But we didn't get pinched by Hashem. We didn't get slapped by Hashem. We got kicked by Hashem. Kicked in the face. So even if a person is sleeping, when he gets kicked, he wakes up and the kick hurts him. If a person doesn't feel any pain from being kicked, that means that he's dead. He's a walking dead man. His heart is of stone. I believe in complete faith in Emuna that everything that Hashem does is for the better good. But I feel the pain and the anguish of the kick. And I believe in full and complete faith in our master and mentor, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. I asked myself, what does Hashem want from us? Let's wait. There are going to be some more questions and then we'll elaborate and explain.
Okay, we'd like to ask if Charlie could just, if he has any additional words or any words of comfort towards what was just said.
I can try. It's been very difficult to follow the Rav, but I can try. You know, many times in life when you go through something, you learn to make yourself stronger afterwards. A lot of times you'll see in Israel, they'll have a war. And then after the war is over, they'll sit down and say, what went right? What went wrong? How can we build the bitachon? How do we build the security so that the next time that we have a war, we're stronger? That's the normal evolution of a human being. He learns. And learning what went right, what went wrong, is part of, I believe, why when you see someone who's older, you are supposed to give kavod and respect, because living life teaches you lessons. When you, and I got this from Rav Arush and from so many others, the way you deal with tragedy, of course, one of the ways is to wake up in the morning and say, I need to be stronger in my emuna. I have to be stronger, because if I'm not stronger, I can't get through the day. So it's not that this tragedy I have to deal with. That's for sure you have to deal with. But it'll also teach us, wait, if I don't have a plan for how to be stronger in my faith, how am I going to get through life? So when you say thank you, Hashem, when you wake up in the morning and you spend time being grateful for what you have, when you slow down and say the brachot and say, wait, my eyes work. Wait, I can walk. Wait, I have a day of life. How many kids right now, how many people would do anything in the world to give their family members another day of life? I have it. It was a gift from this morning. If a person doesn't say to themselves, I have to right now work on my bitachon. I have to this second, because life, I hope, will only give me things that are sweet. But if there's ever going to be something that's not sweet, I have to be prepared. I have to be stronger. I have to go into my life knowing that I've built a stronger armor so that I don't get blown over. When you look at the tzaddikim dealing with Meron and they walk with Emunah and Bitachon, it's because they've been working on themselves for a whole lifetime. They once had a story of Moshe Feinstein, who would walk into, one time he had, back in those days in the Lower East Side, there was one air conditioner in the whole building, and it was a boiling hot day in the summer, and Rav Moshe Feinstein was sitting in the base medrash, not in the air conditioning, and a big bottle of bus, a big gvir came in. And they brought him to the back, and he wanted to meet with the gvir in his office. So you can imagine, he opened his office, and who's sitting at his desk? Who's sitting at his desk? A bachur. A boy sitting at his desk, and he's got his feet up on his chair, on his desk. Can you imagine Rav Moshe Feinstein, the Gadol HaDor, he walks into his office, and one of his students has the air conditioning blasting, is sitting in his chair, and his feet on his desk. Can you imagine?
Wow.
Rav Moshe Feinstein looks in the room and goes, oh, I'm so sorry I bothered you. So no, don't move. We'll meet in the base medrash. And they're like, no, Rabbi, it's okay. He goes, no, you're sitting comfortably.
Wow.
They go, what are you kidding?
Wow.
So they asked Rabbi Feinstein, and they said, how did you do that? He goes, you think I was born this way? My whole life I worked on my midos. My whole life I'm working on what it means to have another Jew in my presence. My whole life I'm working on myself. If there's ever a time where someone should say, I have to work on Emuna and Bitachon every day now, it's right now. Because if there's ever a moment when a person says, the people that are strong can get through anything, it's now.
Emes, Charlie, we really appreciate the words, and because of the technical point that we don't have you on the screen, which we apologize sincerely, it just makes it a little bit harder for the viewers. So we're going to keep the questions and answers very quick. So we move, and not that you didn't, but just I'm just saying for the next question we have, someone asked, my question relates to finding appropriate way to honor the victims of this tragedy. In considering the dimension, the relations of the tragedy, and that we are, as humans, try to find meaning and loss, and are obligated to emulate the tzaddikim, would the dedication for a life of deep daily Zohar study be an appropriate way for this situation and its relations?
שואלים כאן הרב, איך אפשר לבוא ולכבד את זכרם של אותם 45 הקדושים? כיוון שאנחנו רוצים לבוא ולחכות ולהיות כמו הצדיקים, האם להתחיל ללמוד את הזוהר על בסיס יומיומי, זה יהיה משהו שיכבד את זכרם, ובאמת יעשה את הפעולה שרוצים איתנו לעשות?
ודאי וודאי, ודאי שכועד צריך ממש ללמוד כל יום זוהר וכמה שיותר.
Certainly that every single person should learn on a daily basis Zohar as much as he can.
הרי כתוב בזוהר, בחיבור הזה, יצאו מהגלות.
In the Zohar itself, it says that through learning the Zohar, through this writing, this will be how Am Yisrael will go out of exile, of Golos.
ודאי, אני, זה ודאי יש פה, אבי שמעון בר חי בעצמו, צריכים לזכור, אנחנו רק זוכים, רק את 45 שהלכו, ודאי שהלכו, והכאב הוא גדול, צריכים גם לזכור שאבי שמעון בר חי בעצמו, הוא מסר, הפסיד ומסר את השמחה שלו בשביל להשיא את המשרד.
Of course, we know and we are grieving for these 45 holy people who passed away in Meron on Rashbi's Hilula. But we need to remember that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai himself gave up his happiness in order to save Am Yisrael from something much worse. We now need to wake up. We need to learn a lot of Zohar.
הבחור, רבי דוד, יוסף,
יוסף דוד אלחדד.
כן, יוסף דוד אלחדד. הוא כתב לעצמו שאני רוצה ללמוד זוהר מפי רבי שמעון בר חי בעצמו.
One of the young bochrim that was killed in Meron, Yosef David Elchadad, he wrote himself that what he wants is to learn the Zohar from Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai himself. Indeed, he elevated into Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai's yeshiva and is now learning Zohar from him. It is clear that those 45 holy Yidden, they managed to elevate and to reach incredible degrees and levels. The pain that we have is for the families who are feeling and suffering the loss, and for all of Am Yisrael who are going through what they're going through on a daily basis.
We had the merit to do many speeches with Charlie Harary, Mr. Charlie Harary in New York, with Chazak and a fellow Talmud of Moshe Weinberger, Rav Shalom Yonah Weiss. And we have a lot of Akoros HaTov for all those meetings in person, Charlie. And we really pray that we can be able to have them together in person again, like either America or in New York, or you'll come to our studio in Yerushalayim. So as we blessed also Rav Moshe Weinberger and all our other guests, we've had 36 classes and the first time this thing didn't work, but we appreciate you holding on with the line on the phone, and we thank again you being a part of our program and giving us that encouragement. Is there anything you can say from your kahila, just in a more brief way, just what you feel how in America they felt about this in the U.S.
America was broken. Our hearts were totally with you when we found out. During our Lag BaOmer celebration, Rabbi Weinberger actually spoke about this idea of being menatzeach and overcoming. And you should know that in Eretz Yisrael, for those that are listening, you should know that we were watching and crying through the entire time. It was so much that on Motzei Shabbat in America, people didn't know what to do with themselves. We had programs to comfort each other.
Wow.
Because we didn't know what to do. We didn't know where to go. We didn't have anything. A lot of people from America had people that were there. The feeling around the country, I got a call from a tzaddik in Bnei Brak. He said to me that he was so taken by the American response because everyone in America was broken from every denomination, from different religion, different backgrounds.
Wow.
Even Mizrach, Libenu Mizrach. Even though we're in America, our hearts are very much in Eretz Yisrael. Our hearts are very much in Meron, and we feel very much together with you.
Tadar Abba. And that would be a great preparation for Shavuot, which we're meant to be Ishachad Levachad. We'd like to know there was a question about this. How do we get ready for the time of Shavuot and also bring that unity and love that we want to build together from everything we're going through towards the new time of Kabbalah Satorah and our new Chelik Satorah.
איך מחברים כבוד הרב את הנושא הזה של הכנה לשבועות עם האחדות, עם אהבת ישראל, עם כל מה שעברנו במירון, כי איש אחד בלב אחד, איך אנחנו לוקחים את זה בשביל באמת להגיע לזמנים הנשגבים האלה של קבלת התורה מחדש?
אדמה.
On the contrary, this is what happened with Rabbi Akiva's students. Because there was no love between them, that's why Hashem did not want the Torah to pass through them to Am Yisrael. So they died. But Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai said that my whole issue, my main aspect, is love. You cannot receive the Torah without understanding that we have to reach the level of Ahavas Yisroel, of loving each other. Rabbi Natan writes here, because the main aspect of Sefirat HaOmer is to prepare ourselves to receive the Torah on Shavuos. And that is only through this concept of loving each other, of unity among us. So like I said earlier, what does Hashem want from us? We can speak about Ahavat Yisrael infinitely. Of course, it will influence a tiny bit. But we need to do something. We need to take action. We need to truly do something, to take action for there to really be Ahavat Yisrael, loving each other. And I merited receiving a very great gift. I call it Ahavat Yisrael, going to all means, doing Mesirut Nefesh, willing to give up our lives for it. So what did I receive upon myself? And what also did I accept and speak to my whole yeshiva that they should accept upon themselves? And every single day I recruit more people to this concept. We accepted upon ourselves every single day, half an hour, to only pray for Am Yisrael. That's why I call it Ahavat Yisrael b'Mesirut Nefesh, loving Am Yisrael to all means. Because when a person dedicates every single day, half an hour, only for Am Yisrael, and he stands and he prays for half an hour, we started last Shabbat, and thank Hashem, today I did the ninth day. I call it Ahavat Yisrael b'Mesirut Nefesh, loving each other to all means. I already managed to recruit hundreds of people who are joining me on this. I also write the names down of everyone who accepts upon himself to do this. Last Sunday, in Spanish, in the Spanish program, even non-Jews accepted upon themselves to daven for half an hour, only for Am Yisrael, every single day. I asked from Rabbi Yonatan Gal'ed to bring me the list of every single person who accepted upon himself this half an hour on a daily basis. And certainly with all the shiurim that I give. I have here lists from all the classes that I give. And last Tuesday in our German program, they also accepted it upon themselves. He's also going to bring me the list. And last Tuesday, also the French program, many people accepted upon themselves to pray for half an hour on a daily basis. And today, I would like you English speakers to accept upon yourselves to Havat Yisrael, loving Am Yisrael with Mesiris Nefesh, to all means, accept upon yourselves half an hour on a daily basis to pray for Am Yisrael. Everyone who accepts this upon themselves, please write your name down on our Facebook site that you are accepting upon yourself Ahavat Yisrael b'Mesiris Nefesh. They're going to give me all the names. And every single week, I will make an effort to strengthen this issue. Because that is the only hope that we have to expect our full redemption soon and speedily. My son said to me, Father, I don't believe Mashiach is going to come. Look at what's going on. Look at the hatred between people. Look at how many evil things are said from this to this. When he heard that I am recruiting people and that I myself am praying for half an hour on a daily basis, that Am Yisrael will do tshuva without any anguish or difficulties, he said to me, now I truly believe that Mashiach can come. So everyone must literally beg Hashem for half an hour on a daily basis.
And it's
there's no other advice to make peace amongst Am Yisrael. Only by praying and davening to Hashem that Hashem will give every single person the merit to do full and complete
tshuva.
That every single Jew shall know that the main essence and purpose of this world, the main purpose of the Holy Torah, and the main purpose of a person is on his own level, is how to conduct ourselves with our fellow men, how to behave towards each other. So Hashem, please, only you can bring all of Am Yisrael and give them the opportunity to do full tshuva and repent. I'm not talking about our brethren who are far away. That is the easiest thing within Am Yisrael. I'm talking about all the people who are considered to be frum and ultra-Orthodox, all the different types of ultra-Orthodox Jews. They have already tefillin. They're already preserving the Shabbos. They're already upkeeping them. They're already keeping the mitzvahs. But the main part of tshuva, of repentance, they're so far away from it. I pray every single day, Hashem, give them the opportunity to do full tshuva, bring them back. My mentor and teacher, Rabbi Yudah Zev Leibovich, said that when you pray for someone to do complete tshuva, you've got to pray for him to do complete tshuva without any anguish, without any agony. And I believe in the power of prayer. And I have hope that I will recruit tens of thousands of people who will pray every single day for Am Yisrael to do full and complete
tshuva.
And then every single day there'll be tens of thousands of hours of prayer that Am Yisrael will do complete tshuva.
Amen. Rav, we ask Charlie to be a shliach for us in America. Can you help us with this, please, Charlie?
I'm happy to try. Absolutely. What an opportunity to be connected to the Rav in a very deep way, and I'm happy to try to get more people to be connected and to daven for Klal Yisrael. It's a wonderful idea. I can only imagine the rash it's going to make in Shemayim when Jews start to daven for each other and for Klal Yisrael 30 minutes a day. Unbelievable.
So if we can ask around, see if we can generate some feedback. We have the links, we have the ability to work, talk to each other now, thank God, online. If we can hear any feedback about this without giving you too much responsibility, but to even ask around if other people also want to be responsible there, and to get a feeling of Avis Israel in a practical way and bring the names that the Rav can pray for them. And we
30 minutes a day.
Yeah, exactly. 30 minutes a day. And also to see if other Rabbonim and Mashpiyim are interested in the idea. And maybe, like I remember last time we came, you spoke about Thank You Hashem, and you made a big campaign and it was very successful. I watched it online myself with other Rabbonim. If maybe we can take the Avis Israel focus from this class. And part of the Avis Israel, I don't want to neglect, we have Yosef Daniel here. He came all the way from Ramat Beit Shemesh. So we're going to give him an opportunity to sing to us again and get us into a good energy. And maybe he has a question afterwards as well for the Rav and for Charlie. And we'll Messiah the class, Bez Hashem.
We actually have a song that we were discussing before we started. It's called Surrender.
Wow.
So it's something that I wrote a few months ago and will be released pretty soon. And I think it's very much in for this situation at hand that we find ourselves. There's nowhere else to turn. There's nowhere else to run. And when I need to hide, I seek your face, it's so divine. The darkest clouds are gone. My emuna is strong. I know you are my Abba, and you watch me from above. So I surrender all. You heal my broken heart. My head up high, my dreams become your level up. We surrender all. You heal our broken heart. You lift our head up high, my dreams become your level up. So we surrender all. Our head up higher.
we surrender all.
Wow, beautiful. Acceptance, surrender. Amazing.
The Rav was very impressed.
Nice.
Beautiful. Yosef Danil, you have a question for us. And before we do ask, I just want to remind everyone, Yosef Danil has a lot of amazing content, as well as Charlie Harary, both our guests. And we welcome, we put the links always below in the description, how to contact us, how to contact our guests, Charlie and Yosef. Please give us a question and we'll assign the class with this.
So the question that I was thinking is, first of all, I don't feel adequate to ask any questions, to be honest with you.
Fair enough.
But
maybe a comment.
As a observation, I think what we learn is that we're all connected when we contribute to Am Yisrael and the Geula process, when we contribute and all the mitzvot, we're all tied together, we're all one nation. And if that's the case, so it must be that our actions were in some way or another, even in times of tragedy, we're all connected and we all contributed somehow to it. Or maybe we didn't contribute enough to the positive. So I've heard this commented from several of my friends and several of my, you know, Chavruta, and this is the first thing that my Chavruta told me at 2:30 in the morning was, this happened. Have you heard what happened? I don't want to be the shaliach of bad news, but you have to just go look for the information. And he says, you know, I feel culpable. I feel responsible for it. And then another person, and we all feel the pain. So we all feel that, what was I doing at that time? What did I do the day before? We all feel like there's something that we could have done to maybe stop it, to maybe. And after the fact, how do we get over that? I don't want to say guilt, but how do we get past that and strengthen ourselves and push forward?
Yeah, I do feel that the Rav and Charlie had answered somewhat the question, but maybe yes, the Rav Elgrod will help us ask the Rav in a way that brings out a new point.
Kod Rav, Rabbi Yosef Shoel, מאחר ואנחנו כולנו, כל עם ישראל מחוברים. אומר, אז אנחנו מחוברים גם בעיתות, גם בעיתות של שמחה וגם בעיתות של צרה. אומר, יש תחושה של כולם שבאיזשהו מקום זו אחריות שלנו. אולי עשינו משהו שבגלל זה קרה. איך אנחנו מחזיקים את עצמנו להתגבר על רגשות האשמה האלה, האחריות הזאת?
ודאי שאסור לפעול שום עצבות ושום מה שהאשמה עצמית, להסכים להתעורר, לעשות איזה מעשה, לתקן.
Certainly you're not allowed to fall into sadness, into self-guilt. You need to take action. We need to do something to mend the situation.
זה מה ש... זה ההצעה שאני מציע.
This is the offer that I just said.
שכל יתחיל שלא יעשה במשהו של עם ישראל.
That everyone should start doing something for עם ישראל.
זה לא משהו, זה הרבה מאוד.
And it's not something, it's a lot.
אהבת ישראל במסירות נפש.
Loving עם ישראל with מסירות נפש, to all means.
כל יום, כל אחד יזכה. ממש להתפלל כל יום, תחנן בראש העולם, תחזיר אותם מסוימת, תחזיר אותנו בתשובה שלמה.
That every single day you shall merit to pray to Hashem, Hashem, help Am Yisrael do תשובה, help us do תשובה.
אתה אוהב את הקדוש ברוך הוא?
You love Hashem?
תתפלל לבנים שלו.
Pray for his children.
אתה אוהב את האחים שלך?
You love your brothers?
תתפלל עליהם.
Pray for them.
ממילא אין, אין לנו, אין, אין, אנחנו יודעים את הבעיות, יודעים מה, מה הבעיה.
We know the problems. We know what the problem is.
יודעים שהבעיה זה שנאת חינם.
We know the problem is שנאת חינם, hating each other for no reason.
יודעים שהבעיה זה מחלוקות.
We know the problem is arguments and disputes.
לשון הרע.
We know the problem is saying evil things about each other.
מה אנחנו יכולים לעשות?
So what can we do?
אבל להתפלל אנחנו כן יכולים.
But to pray, that is something that we can do.
אז נזכה שכולם, יעשו כולם, התחילו לדעת עיקר זה ממש לאהוב כל יהודי, וכל עד, ברגע שאדם בעצמו התפלל חצי שעה לעם ישראל, אז הוא מקבל בעצמו את אהבת ישראל.
And may we merit that everyone should know the main thing is Ahavat Yisrael, loving each other. And when you start praying half an hour for Am Yisrael, you yourself receive this gift of Ahavat Yisrael, of loving Am Yisrael. Someone said to me, I accepted upon myself this Ahavat Yisrael b'msirut nefesh, praying for half an hour for Am Yisrael to do tshuva. He said to me, bless me. I said to him, I need to bless you. Hashem is blessing you. Like HaKadosh Baruch Hu said to Avraham Avinu, I'm blessing those who bless you. And Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, that he promised that through him the Torah will never be forgotten from Am
Yisrael.
When you're praying for Am Yisrael to do tshuva and to learn the Holy Torah, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai himself is blessing you because you're helping him to keep his promise. And all the righteous people from the from Moshe Rabbeinu till today, they're all blessing you. And this is something I'm telling you, this is a certainty, this is a tested certainty, that anyone who prays for half an hour on a daily basis, he will have heaven on this earth. Everything will work out for him. Because when you're praying for Hashem's children, all of creation is praying for you.
Wow, Charlie, how can you follow
Yosef,
that up?
Yosef, you accepted upon yourself?
Yeah. Yosef accepted. Charlie,
so now the rob is going to write down your name.
We want your name as well, Charlie.
יוסף דניאל בן אברהם.
יוסף דניאל בן אברהם.
יושב
עליך. היא מציון.
Okay, we're putting your name down, yeah?
Yeah.
Baruch Hashem. We want to welcome also everyone. We're going to be, for next Emuna class, going to be Shavuot, the beautiful Chag of Kabbalah Satorah. Please God, all the souls will be elevated. Everyone will come to the unity and love that the Rav is talking about. And everyone will be mekayem this to pray.
I want my name also in that list.
Yes, Rav Dayan Elgrod's name.
Elchanan Shalom Ben Shoshana Beinu.
Okay, and now you have to put my name also. We're all, Baruch Hashem, the studio people, even more so need to put their names. Anyway, we love them. With all the technical issues, we thank everyone.
People should start writing their names down.
Write your names down on the YouTube, on the Facebook. I will keep checking there and I'll collect them and get them to the
Rabbi. Pass the names to the Rabbi.
And not just them, it has to be real. The real Mesiras Nefesh, with all our energy and will to pray for the people, to have love and unity, like we have our beautiful brand, Ani Ohev Kol Yehudi, but also we love all people. So we want to also invite you for the following week after Shavuot to join us with Meilech Kohn. He's going to please join us here, the singer Meilech Kohn, and we'll have him in the studio. We'd wish Charlie could be here in person, be a whole different energy. And we apologize again that we didn't get to see his beautiful face and smile. But can you end off, Charlie, with just a little word of chizuk about this, please?
Care about each other, we love each other, and the more we feel each other's pain and share each other's joy, the more we will become the one body that we really are and reach the level of a Yichan Sham Yisrael Neged Ahar Kivisha Chad Levecha, the way Hashem wants it. And then maybe if we did that or even tried to do that, Hashem will help. Like, you know, when the kid tries to make a Lego and the father finishes it for him, Hashem just sees us trying, and then that hopefully he'll finish it and go, you know what, they're trying. Come this Shavuot, we'll be able to then finish it completely for Kal Yisrael and be able to see the Gilui of the Shechinah of Hashem, Be'ezrat Hashem Yitbarach, and then Ad Biyad Kol Mashiach B'Nehra B'Amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you. We have a final song to just end the class from Yosef and Neil together. We want to hear your singing voice, Charlie.
Give it to you, take the Torah, and try to show you Shalom. Give it to you, take the Torah, and try to show you Shalom. Give it to you, take the Torah, and try to show you Shalom. Give it to you, take the Torah, and try to show you Shalom.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Shkoyach, Charlie, come again in person. Thank you so much. We love you.